First, we talk about the document object storage in general. So the data model of a document object store is that it allows you to store semi-structured data, for instance, JSON and XML. So a document therewith contains data with additional structural information. Here we see an example where we have two documents, document one and document two, and these documents can contain sub-documents. Here's subdocument one, subdocument three, and subdocument two. And a document can contain values, value one, for instance, here. But it can also contain references between different documents. So as subdocument one, we have a reference to document two, subdocument two, which is this one, for example. So how we can find initially a document is implementation specific. There are various solutions. You can have, for example, a simple bucket document key solution where you have to identify the bucket and then specify a key. There are ways of organizing collections in hierarchical namespaces and so forth. So we will look into MongoDB, but there are additional solutions around that all rely on a similar concept. So what is MongoDB? It's an open source document database. It's high performant and horizontally scalable. Horizontally scalable means you can add more nodes that then with storage and MongoDB servers that then add their capabilities to this cluster. It has various interfaces that we'll look about and also connectors for Hadoop. So it has basically the data model that we discussed. So, and defines permissions on top of it. The documents that you store are JSON documents. So here we see an example JSON document here with the value ID and two students, an area stored in an array here, where one is Julian and one is Hans. Internally, it actually stores this JSON as a BSON, which is a binary JSON. And the subdocuments in this example are pretty much here students, which is this array of additional, you could think of, subdocuments. So then you have a collection, which is like a table of documents. So we have not a single of those documents, but many documents. And how we can address and find a document is by specifying the name of the collection and then using, for example, this ID that we have in each document. Documents can have different schemas. So you can have a schema, for example, for each document, but typically you would impose a schema on a collection level. You can also have indexes on different fields, and typically you use these references, the document ID. MongoDB allows you to do various operations on the data. Of course, you can create, read, update, and delete, which is in short CRUD, for the initials of each of these operations that are typical to any kind of storage solution, particularly object storage. Additionally, you can find data which has certain properties. You can sort the data and you can actually perform some kind of computation operations like aggregations to accumulate different fields inside our JSON documents. On the collection level, you can create and drop, which means removing collections. They are automatically, in fact, created when you insert the first document in a collection. You can use schemas to support the document validation. That means when you create a collection, you can also define a validator. And every time you insert a document, it checks that the document has a certain structure that you specified in its validate. This allows you to reject the changes that you make to a document or the inserts. So when you do an update or an insert, then checked. So in terms of semantics, the ID field, the underscore ID field is always created, but you can also define a unique ID as a string, and this ID field really must be unique because it specifies the document inside one of these collections. So you have an atomicity guaranteed on the document level. It means when you make changes to a document, to one document at a time, all these changes happen atomically at once. However, when you change multiple documents in a series of operations, well, some of these changes may happen while others are rejected. In that sense, all fields that must be updated together must be part of one document. Okay, that is a design consideration that results from this atomicity property. So we have durability. In MongoDB, there is a bit of flexibility. So users can define a wide concern, which specifies when the operation should complete and how safe the data has been written back. This improves performance by relaxing the durability, but it may lead to potential data loss if you modify data. In terms of concurrency, internally it uses read-write exclusive logs to ensure that everything works properly, and you can use bulk operations for inserts, which speeds up the, or for all kind of operations, in fact, which speeds up performance as well. Now, to find documents, you can use a so-called query document. In this sense, you can select the and search for documents by defining another JSON document. It works like this. You specify the find operation with a query and a projection. So query defines the search for which properties shall be found in the document you look for, and projections pretty much define what kind of data fields you are interested in that should be returned of a document. So kind of a rich document, and parts of it is used in a query and parts of it is basically returned. And here are examples given as part of this query, which basically is a filter. So you can say, for example, I compare it with a set of data using the $in operator. So you can say I have a certain key that you specify, like the name should be in this value 1 or value 2. And there are various expressions. Here's another example for a query document. You can say a student.age must be greater than 15. And if you put this into a query document, you will get all the document contents back that matches these properties. So typically you may want to say in the projection then, give me the IDs of these documents that have students age bigger than 15, or maybe give me the names, something like that. So it's a little bit simpler than SQL, but it's also quite powerful.